Good morning to the distinguished jury members and my esteemed colleagues from the across the industries. This is Pratin Dutta, Head of Logistics, will be presenting on the best supply chain practices and logistics implemented in JKCL. So I thank CII for giving us this forum to present our cases. To start with the company background, I'll not take much time on this. We are a leading cement manufacturer in the country and with a portfolio of around four decades. Current million ton capacities of around 14.6. We started with 0.3 in 1975, and with greenfield projects on the anvil, we are going to take it up to 19.6 within few years. We have a vision to be the preferred manufacturer of cement and cement based products in the partners in the nation building. We have our mission to be in innovative design, innovative products and solutions to meet the customer needs. We have our core values of integrity, quality, trust, care and people. Now coming to the core of our presentation, the cases which are going to present today is basis on the pandemic situation, what we have developed and to sustain our business in the market. We start with dedicated trade model, which relates to the performance management with focus on return, stock on bill, execution to resolve and speed with sustainability, e-auction, visibility of change and turnaround through technology, GPS footprint, tracking in the pandemic, innovation and collaboration within and outside the organization, safety for business partners, that is social responsibilities and ethical practices. Contactless supply chain relates to use of technology. If I come to the first case, we talk about dedicated fleet model. The concept behind it was to create a pool of pool of fleets by our business partners, which will run dedicatedly for JKCL, enhancing the customer delight, which will deliver as per the requirement of the agreed business and commercial terms, creating a win-win situation for both the business partner and the organization. The approach was to create around 200 plus fleets moving from plants to various markets across the country. Business partners were ensured with guaranteed fixed volume and return, catering to critical and priority orders. Green channel was created for these to prioritize loading and unloading in plant and as well as warehouses. Reverse logistics, these fleets were maximizes the inbound and outbound movement, that is raw material and cement, and benefit in freight compared to the existing market freight. Customer delight due to better and faster delivery, increasing OET, average freight gain since June 19 from the initiative is rupees 65 per metric ton pan India level. And by March 21, we have a plan to ramp up this volume to by 400 plus. Now what we learned? We learned by this model that we have showcased our business partners that with proper management of fleets, we can increase turnaround time and overall operational efficiency during this pandemic situation where the market is volatile in nature. These are the pictorial representations of the dedicated fleet model which we have created, which is moved from our plants to various markets. Coming to the second concept, that is we call stock on wheels. Now with this ongoing pandemic situation, the market behavior has become very volatile. Hence, to increase the market penetration with this customer delivery, we have introduced SOW, that is stock on wheel, across India. The approach was to identify the locus points in various markets where the designated vehicles are being moved, and upon reaching the desired destinations, further orders are generated for multiple customer deliveries with agreed radius. Now, with this customized delivery and reduced lead time, we are creating a brand visibility in the markets for better reach. The benefit we got from this since February, savings in secondary freight and warehouse handling, resulting in a gain of rupees 150 per metric ton. By March 21, we're expecting it to ramp up this volume by utilizing the existing and further introducing new SOW to the markets, but direct delivery to customers are comparatively low. What we learned is successfully increased market share of urban markets by catering smaller deliveries. We further increase our products presence in interior rural markets, thereby giving us an edge over our competitors. These are the pictorial representation of a stock on wheel, which branded with JKCL. Now I come to the third of idea, that is of e-auction, what we call bidding. In this current business scenario, the biggest challenge is to sustain. So to sustain in the supply chain, logistics plays a very pivotal role in optimizing the cost and thereby creating a better contribution to the organization. One of the smartest ways to do is to optimize the freight through e-auction by creating vendor competitiveness and outpost utilization of demand supply scenario. The approach was of integration of transport management system with our ERP system, providing a portal to the business partners to bid strategically, targeting those markets with ample fleets and key customer sites with bulk orders to reap the maximum benefit out of the e-auction. The benefit what we got of is that catering to 65% of the total dispatch volume currently, and average savings since December 19 of this initiative is rupees 11 per metric ton. What we learned? We learned that bidding is a process which is driven by demand-supply scenario of the market and thereby creating an opportunity to exercise the leverage on the cost parameters. I come to the fourth one. GPS is known for tracking and tracing, but we use the same GPS for footprint tracking in pandemic. An initiative which was taken by us during this pandemic, the entire routes and drop locations were divided into red, orange and green zones across all the destinations based on the updated zone list provided by the government portals, which were regularly updated. Now, the fleets were monitored live through our portal and alerts were triggered before 50 kilometers prior to reaching the destination. Now, the destination, the be it plant, warehouse or customer, could see from which zone the fleets were coming during the trip prior to reaching the location. In each case of these fleets coming through orange or red zone, special precautions with enhanced sanitization were arranged for incoming fleets along with the drivers and helpers. In many cases, alternate routes were identified to avoid red zones to ensure the non-stop travel and also for safety reasons. Now, what we learned, the GPS is primarily used for tracking, but our out-of-the-box thinking has actually enabled us to ensure safety of our business partners during this pandemic outbreak. So the fifth one was talking about the business modulation to counter this pandemic. Many of our colleagues have spoken about this. We also supported the business partners in all these situations, inquired about safety, educated them about the Arogya Setu app, briefed about the paperless initiative, explained why government is not reducing diesel rates, e-bill submission process for faster TAT, unloading to be done within 2 hours, creation of grievance cells, suggested business partners to appoint safety officer, educated about loan moratorium, which was rapidly welcomed by all the business partners, and thanked the JKCL for addressing their concerns in these challenging times. This is some of the glimpses of the initiatives we have taken in the warehouse, which the pictures shows it all. And this is in the plant. We have sanitized the trucks. We have showed them about the do's and don'ts, distributed sanitizers and masks, and we thank them for their services, for dedication towards helping others. The last but not the least is the contactless supply chain, the transformation of manual LR and DI process to digitized auto-generated LR and DI through transport management system, installation of manless web bridges at plants, instant verification and faster payments, e-freight bills through vendor portal, transparent payment reconciliations, automated invoicing, approval workflows and reduced freight costs. Successful pilot of both EPUD and vendor transporter portal have been implemented, and we are on the verge of implementation across all the plant locations.
Great.
So the learning is that, ensured social distancing, and that is we call paperless supply chain. This is some of the pictorial representation where we are talking about manless web bridges. And in conclusion, I would like to say that, the entire industry is witnessing a very different scenario due to this pandemic outbreak, and JKCL is no exception. Under the circumstances, our motto is to, when the going gets tough, the tough gets going, which helped us in conceiving various initiatives to sustain and excel. The initiatives are a perfect blend of utilization and technology and creating a value chain excellence in the business process, along with the social responsibility towards our business partners and the society as a whole. Since its inception, JKCL has been known for the robust foundation and creating an impact on environment and society. During the current pandemic crisis, the organization has taken several steps in digitization to sustain and create business process excellence. As compared to the industry, JKCL has maintained market positions as one of the pioneers in cement industry and have established a wide market reach by tapping every possible opportunities in the construction sector and focus on brand visibility, resulting in customer delight. I thanks once again to all of you for giving us opportunity. Thank you,
Mr. Datta. Any questions, Jury?
No, fine.
Yeah, I have just one question. Stock on wheels is what I liked the objective. Sure. Is it something that is nearby to your plants, or is all India kind of operation on stock on wheels?
Sir, we have around 6 plants, mostly located in Rajasthan, one in Gujarat and one in South. So it is, we are talking about, range of 100-150 kilometers, where, the direct dispatches are comparatively low. So we are creating a brand visibility through the stock on wheels concept, where the truck will go to the market and wait there, and orders are generated, which are again diverted to the customer points within 2 to 3 points or radius of 20 to 30 kilometers.
I understood the model, but I was wondering how you expanded this, or it's a little restricted kind of. Okay, thanks.
Sir.
Okay. That's it. Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Pratim Datta.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, sir.